My animation and physics sim expander add-on for Blender got another big update yesterday. I've always wanted to break a mesh up into chunks. Self-fracture can do this, but the problem is the cracks that appear, so you can't really use it for assembly, and people can tell it's been cut up before you even break it. I realized that the Voxelize function in the add-on had me halfway there. So I added a new feature to it and we'll have to think of a new name now. Let's go over the Voxelize function's features so you can make the most of this part of the add-on for your motion graphics and physics simulation needs. My add-on is found on Blender Market and a link is in the description. Voxelize is super simple to use. You just need to pick a target mesh and a type of object you'd like to use. By default, we have cube, sphere, icosphere, and custom. Cube is the default and will trace the object you've given it, making an object in all the places where it detects an overlap. Size is pretty important. The lower it goes, the more objects will be made. The trace will be better, but it'll be harder on your machine with more objects. If fill is checked, it'll keep those voxels that are in the middle of the target so that it won't be hollow. This is harder on your PC, so I let you choose. Custom is pretty neat, but whether it will work out or not depends on the shape you pick. I'll show you a little more about custom momentarily. Once you have your voxels, you can hide the original mesh and use the voxels for assemblies or physics simulations by using the add-on's animation and add rigid body features. As you can see, you can pick a material and this will be applied to the objects. If you select colorize, you can pick an image texture and each voxel will get the color from the spot it was born on. If you use fill, you can choose not to color the internal voxels and they will just take on the default color of the material you chose. Now let's talk about the new Boolean mode. This is a big deal to me because it brings one of my Blender dreams to life, and I think a lot of people are gonna like it. You'll notice a handy checkbox to change the mode of the script. What this will do is use the standard cube, sphere, or a custom object to do the same thing, only this time it will aim to cut the mesh up into pieces of itself. The fast checkbox is on by default, but this is only there to improve accuracy based on the mesh. Sometimes a Boolean modifier's accurate mode is better, but far from always, and for many simple meshes, fast is better. As you can see, in this mode, we get to pick two materials. If you do something like the shuttle I showed, pick the same material the shuttle is using, and the outside will be colored just like it. The inside will have the second material. You don't want the insides to use the same one because it looks awful and it has no idea how to map them. It doesn't always work, but I can show you a quick fix for this. Pick all the objects and go into edit mode. Swoop around the object, holding shift to select more faces. Just make sure you're not in wireframe or some mode where you will pick internal faces. On the materials tab, just apply the material that has the correct color on it. Just patch up the tricky spots and it'll look great. Now, on to custom objects. If I create my own cube, smash it down on the X and make it bigger on Z and Y, I'll have a large but thin panel. If I pick this as the custom object, the script will use this instead of a cube. Now I do need to apply the scale, but once I've done that, I can play around with size and run it until I get something I like. As you can see, this torus was cut up into tiny slivers from a long thin object. If you subdivide the custom object, you'll sometimes get a better result. Using this and playing around with proportions, you can get some really nice fractures. So I am still working hard on my add-on for customers. If you like what I've done here, subscribe to be notified of new videos. And if you've bought my add-on and love it, be sure and leave me a review. You'll find a link to buy it in the description.